Hey guys, how are you guys doing today? Y'all good? Y'all good? All right. I am back with another video for y'all. This little clip right here is just like when I'm be uploading and stuff like that. So I have a goal to reach by the end of this year. I want to reach 1,000 subscribers or more by the end of this year if I can. We only like 500 something away. So let's do that. I will be uploading every Sunday and every Wednesday. So make sure you guys are, turn your post notifications on. Make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel. Like my videos, comment down below some video ideas you guys would like to see, pranks, challenges, anything, just let me know and I got y'all, okay? Make sure you leave it down in the comments below and I got y'all on what y'all want to see. But yeah, I just wanted to give y'all that and let y'all know every Sunday and Wednesday you guys will be getting a video from me. And let's get 1,000 subscribers or more by the end of this year. Let's do it.
Oh my God.
Can I sing to you? Yeah.
Yours, mine, ours. I could do this for hours.
Alright. Alright, y'all. Let's get into this video. So, this video is about my kids' donor. We're not even going to say father. We're going to say donor. What was that? Anyways, we're going to talk about this man that I really don't like to talk about. But after this, I don't want nobody asking me no question about this man. Why y'all don't see this man? Why I don't talk to this man? Why I don't talk about this man? Okay? Don't ask me because you will get blocked. Like, that is my biggest pet peeve. Is when motherfuckers try to talk to me and then they be like, oh, well, what about your kid's father? Da, da, da. My baby don't have one of those. Okay. I am her mother and her father. She don't have one of those. Okay. But anyways, let's get into it. Okay, so let me just start from the beginning. So, we met in like, I want to say March or April 2018. I think it was April, but then again, I could be wrong and it could be March. It was one of them 2 months right there, okay? We met, we was talking, he followed me on Instagram, and then he slid in my DMs. And then I think like a week or so later, I was at work, and he was like, oh, I want to see you. And I'm like, okay, I'm like a dummy. And I went to his house. Didn't even know this man. And I went. But he picked me up from work, and I went to his house. And we was chilling, you know, we did what we did. But I didn't get pregnant. Okay. Just listen to the story. So we was talking for a couple of months. And then I think I was at his house one day. And he was trying to, like, check me about something. And I'm like, nigga, who do you think you're talking to? Because you're not talking to me. Pause. Like, pump your brakes, sir. And then he was like, he got a little attitude. And he was like, you act like you can't be checked. And da-da-da. I cannot, baby. Especially by a nigga. Especially by you. For one, we're not even together. So who do you think you finna check? Not me? Okay. So then he was like, I'm cool on you. I was like, okay, you can take me home. He was like, oh, I mean for the moment. Okay, well, I don't even want to talk to you right now. You can still take me home. So we was talking for a couple months and then whatever. This is how I knew it was a red flag then. And I should have just aborted the whole fucking mission. In the beginning, this motherfucker tried to get me pregnant. He was like, we could move together. Nigga, pump your brakes. You're moving too fast. No, we're not. We're not doing all that. Stop. But anyways, I didn't. So we was talking or whatever. And then, I don't know what the fuck happened. I went to the hospital for something. Oh, I be having like real bad chest pain. Like, and it like burned. So I be going to the hospital. And then, like, a couple of days after I went to the hospital, whatever, he texted me and was like, oh, you can't come back over because you gave me such and such. And I'm like, nigga, what? Like, are you texting the right person? Because I ain't give you shit, baby, because I ain't got nothing to give you. So what the fuck are you talking about? And he was like, I just left the hospital. I said, I just left the hospital 2 days ago. Like, I don't have nothing. They would have told me. He was like, well, you can't come back over until you get checked. Baby, I won't come back over ever. I'm not coming back over. So we stopped talking after that. I think that was in like June. So we was only talking for like 2 months at that time. So like
That was like June, July, we stopped talking. So it was June, actually, we stopped talking. So July, the nigga posted an ultrasound picture saying he was gonna have a baby. Actually, he sent it to me in my DMs. And I'm like, okay. But in my head, I'm like, hold on. It's all clicking. Like, you try to say I gave you something, well, clearly it was this bitch who gave you something. Because the way, how far along pregnancy is adds up to the time that me and you were still messing around. Do your math, baby. So, that's who gave you something. And then I tried to tell him. He was like, oh, and I'm having a boy. Like, you're going to be the stepmom. And, nigga, I'm not stepping shit. I am stepping out of your life. Like, leave me alone. What do you want? Okay, so then he was like, I'm having a boy or whatever. So I was like, I calculated. I'm like, bro, she got to be at least 3 to 4 months for you to know what you're having. And he was like, no, she's 10 weeks, almost 12, 11, 10, 11, some shit weeks. And I'm like, nigga, do your math. There's 4 months, 4 weeks in a month. 12 weeks, nigga, that's 3 months. Like I said. We were still talking when you got this bitch pregnant. That's who gave you what the fuck you trying to say I gave you. Anyways, so yeah, that happened to her. We stopped talking for months. Like, I was like, I'm not even gonna deal with you. Like, I go be with your baby mama. So we stopped talking. So I was working down the hill and he decided to slide in my DMs again. Text my phone, whatever the fuck he did. And he was like, oh, I miss you and I wanna see you. And my big dumb ass was like, when or whatever. He was like, tonight I'ma come over or whatever. But we were staying in the room because we was working down a hill at this place. So we were staying down the hill. So I was like, oh, we stay in the room right now. He was like, okay, I'll just come and we can sit outside or whatever. He came. We went outside. Let me tell y'all what the fuck I had on. I had on boxers and a jacket, I think. Like, why would you go outside and some shit like that? Knowing this man as fine as he is. And they don't, ladies, do not listen to a nigga when he say he just wants to come talk. We could talk over the phone. We don't need to talk in person. That's what I should have told his ass. But I didn't. So I let him come. We was talking. Next thing you know, we ended up in the backseat. And yeah. You know, one thing led to the next. So the next day he texted me. This was in like October, the end of October, 2018. All of this happened in 2018. In October, that's when he came to see me or whatever. And then we did what we did in the car. And then the next day, he texted me on some bullshit and was like, oh, I think I nutted. Bitch, you think or you did? Like, ain't no think. He's like, I did. I'm like, okay, well, what do you want me to do about it? And he was like, we can get a plan B. You can buy the plan B. I'm not buying shit because this is your doing. You did this, not me. So he bought it. I took it. We wasn't talking. A couple weeks went by. I think like 2 weeks. 2-3 weeks went by. And I'm like, Mother Nature is not knocking on this door, baby. She didn't come at all. So I text him. I'm like, I don't think that shit worked. And he was like, oh, well, we can go down to get an abortion. Baby, I'm not doing that. We laid down and did what we did. So you need to man up and take care of what come with it. And he didn't. So I was pregnant my whole life. 9 months by myself. I did everything by myself. Like, during the month, I would text him, like, because, you know, I don't want my kid to grow up without a father. So I would text him, like, you know, it's a girl. I'm due such and such. I have a baby shower this day if you want to come or whatever. And he wasn't for none of it. So I was just like, I'm not even going to keep trying. Once my daughter came, I was like, I'm done. Like, I don't even give up. Fast forward to when my daughter did come. Oh, y'all, and it's some other parts. It was another nigga that was claiming a baby that wasn't even his. Like, but we're not going to talk about him because he's not relevant to the story at all. But yeah, so after I had my baby or whatever, I think like maybe... I don't even think he was messaging, like, we wasn't even talking, like, after I had her. I think it was, like, December 2019. I had my daughter July 2019. My daughter's, like, 5 months. They wanted to do a DNA test. Because he's like, oh, I don't think she's mine. Boy, this baby look like you. How the fuck is she not yours? Try to say I was out sleeping around on him. When you the one who got another bitch pregnant while we were still talking. Be for real. All right, hold on. I have to give me some water. It's hot. All right, so yeah. December 2019, I think it was like a couple of days before Christmas, him and his mom came over to get a DNA test. And like, when I tell you my kid looks like these people, how are you denying this kid? So they took the DNA test. He came, like, he didn't want to hold her or nothing. They was there for like 10 minutes max, took the DNA test, and they left. Which was fine with me, because I didn't want to see the motherfucker to begin with. So then, okay, we did the DNA test, and then after a while, he was messaging me again. He was like, oh, well, actually, after the results came back, that the baby was 99.9% motherfucking his, like I told him from the beginning. He messaged me and was like, oh, well, I'm going to be there, yada, 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 all that bullshit. And he was like, oh, well, I just want to let you know I'm finna have another baby. What the fuck is you telling me for? We're not finna be together at all. Like, I don't want you. It's not happening. He was like, oh, I just thought you should know. That's not something I need to know. That don't have nothing to do with me or my child. I do not care. So yeah. Since then, he's probably seen my kid, I could count on both of these hands, maybe 10 times since he's seen my kid. Like, it'd be times where I have to like text him like, oh, I miss you. Like, I want to see you, whatever. Come over, whatever. Only for him to come. Like, if I'd be like, your kid wants to see you, like, oh, well, I can't make it. Nigga, you is a bitch. Let's start there. Hold on, because I do have receipts as well. Look at this. Yeah. So, let me go to the first one. Where is it? I am literally scrolling through Instagram messages, trying to find these messages for y'all. It's a lot of scrolling because it was like 4 years ago, so I'll be back when I find them. So like, I was still pregnant on some of these messages. He would message me like, oh, how is she? Nigga, she's in my stomach, motherfucker. She's mine. He like, can I be in her life? Like, nigga, I never said you could not. You the weirdo who don't want to be here. So that's on you. And then I was trying to get the nigga last name. We was just sneaky linking. I didn't need to know your social and all that type of shit. I didn't need to know all that. Because it wasn't supposed to be more than what that was. You feel me? So don't come for me in the comments. Because I come back. Okay. So yeah, I was trying to get, you know, I had to do some child support. I was trying to do the child support. And I was like, I need your name, like, so I can give her your last name or whatever. This man did not want to give me his last name. I'm like, okay, whatever. You're a weirdo. Okay, so right here while I was still praying, he was like, I have full intentions on being an active father upon Kamari's arrival. He lied. That motherfucker was not active at all. Still not active. So then I was like trying to get his number so we could communicate like through text messages, like we have a kid together. This motherfucker said no, we could just talk on Instagram. I'm not finna keep messaging you on Instagram. I'm not finna talk to you at all. Like, what the fuck do I look like? So yeah, that was those. So fast forward to now, this man does not do nothing. He does not see my kid. He barely calls her. He calls her maybe like once every 2-3 months. Try to tell her what to do, how to act. Like, oh, y'all. Then this man got the nerve to tell me, because we was arguing about something, and he was like, you don't know what it takes to be a father. You are a mother. I'm pretty sure they kind of take the same thing, you dummy. I was like, you don't know what it is either, because clearly you're not a father. So yeah, that's the story on this bastard. I'm not gonna go into nothing else because I'm just getting irritated talking about this man in general. So yeah, don't ask me no more questions about this man. This man does not come around. I'm not showing y'all who this man is. His name is DJ, and that's all the fuck y'all gonna get to know. I hope y'all like this video, and like, comment down below some other videos you guys like to see that ain't got nothing to do with me talking about this motherfucker. Y'all want to see some videos with me and Kamari while she over here sleep right now? Let me know. Also, I am going to do a video of me interviewing her, asking her some questions stuff. So y'all comment down below some questions that y'all want me to ask my 4-year-old daughter. And yeah, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel. And yeah, I don't know why the fuck I keep saying. And yeah, but I do. So yeah. I was going to say something else. But yeah, y'all help me get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of this year. Have a good day.